If you turn in your Bibles, please, to the book of Daniel.
Bon, if Neil, Sefer Daniel.
Sefer Daniel, the prophet Daniel. Chapter 5.
Perek Hei.
Daniel was in Babylon.
Daniel nimtza bevavel.
And the king of Babylon, a very ungodly person,
והמלך של בבל היה איש רשע ומרושע.
Threw a huge banquet.
הוא הזמין אנשים לסעודה גדולה.
And the Babylonian kings and others were famous for gigantic parties that ended up in drunken orgies.
והמלך הזה היה מפורסם בהקמת סעודות ואלכוהול ואורגיות וחטא.
So Daniel is in Babylon and one of these feasts are taking place.
אז דניאל היה בבבל בזמן החגיגות האלה.
There were at least 1,000 lords there.
היו לפחות 1,000 אנשים שם.
Wives, concubines, prostitutes.
היו חכמים, היו פילגשים, והיו כאלה זונות.
There were singers, there were musicians, there were dancers.
היו שם מוסיקאים, היו רקדנים וזמרים.
It was just one wild all-night party.
אז הייתה כזאת לילה של מסיבה פרועה.
And it says here, verse 2, that they began, the king commanded that gold and silver vessels would be brought in from that had been in the temple in Jerusalem.
ויאמר בלשאצר בטוב ליבו ביין להביא את כלי הזהב והכסף שלקח נבוכדנצר אביו מן ההיכל אשר בירושלים.
All the party guests
כל האורחים של המסיבה הזאת
started drinking from the sacred vessels that had been taken from the temple in Jerusalem and had been brought to Babylon.
התחילו לשתות יין בתוך הכלים הקדושים שנלקחו מבית המקדש בירושלים אל בבל.
In verse 4,
פסוק 4,
they drank wine and praised the gods of gold and silver, bronze and iron and wood and stone.
הם שתו יין ונתנו שבח לאלוהי זהב וכסף נחושת וברזל עץ ואבן.
As this horrible blasphemous party was reaching its climax, probably the music was getting wilder. People were getting drunk. God only knows what they were doing there. But as this happened, in verse 5, in the same hour, the fingers of a man's hand appeared and wrote opposite the lampstand on the plaster of the wall of the king's palace. And the king saw part of what the hand had wrote.
אותה שעה יצאו אצבעות של יד אדם וכתבו מול הנברשות על הטיח שעל כותל היכל המלך וירא המלך את פס היד הכותבת.
In this wild, wild scene,
בסצנה הזאת הנוראית,
of thousands of people worshiping and praising and singing to the gods of gold and silver,
אלפי אנשים מזמרים ושרים ומשתחווים לאלילי זהב וכסף,
all of a sudden opposite the menorah, maybe it was the menorah even taken from the temple, I don't know,
אפילו לפתע מול המנורה שכנראה נלקחה מההיכל בירושלים,
a man's hand appeared
פס יד של אדם נראתה
and began engraving words on the wall.
והתחילה לרשום מילים על הקיר.
And as the king looked,
והמלך הביט,
he was horrified.
והוא נבהל.
He was terrified.
והוא פחד.
His knees started knocking together.
וגם הברכיים שלו רעשו.
He was panic-stricken.
והוא הוכה בפחד.
He was traumatized. Can we look at this picture?
והייתה לו טראומה, בואו נראה את התמונה הזאת.
Here's a famous painting of this scene.
זה כנראה שציור של הסצנה הזאת.
Here's the king with all the wild party going on around him.
המלך וכל המסיבה הפרועה מסביב.
And you can see the hand writing on the wall.
ואתם רואים את הפס היד שכותבת על הקיר.
And the king is terrified.
והמלך נבהל.
The so-called wise men of Babylon couldn't interpret what those words meant.
כל החכמים והחרטומים בבבל לא ידעו לפרש את המילים האלה.
So they called in the prophet Daniel.
אז הם קראו לנביא דניאל.
And Daniel comes into this horrible scene.
ודניאל הגיע אל המחזה הנוראי הזה.
And look at what he says.
תראו מה הוא אמר.
Verse 23. You have lifted yourself up against the Lord of heaven. They have brought the vessels of his house before you and your wives and your concubines. You've praised the gods of silver and bronze and gold and stone, and the God who holds your breath in his hand and owns all your ways you have not glorified.
ויתרומם על אדון השמיים את כלי ביתו הביאו לפניך ואתה ושריך ונשיך ופלגשיך שתיתם בהם יין ונתתם שבח לאלוהי חסד וזהב נחושת וברזל עץ ואבן שאינם רואים ואינם שומעים ואינם יודעים ששיבחתם אותם ואת האלוהים אשר נשמתך בידו וכל אורחותיך מסורים לו לא הודית.
I've been thinking about this scene for a number of months.
אני חשבתי על המחזה הזה הרבה פעמים.
As the ungodly flood gets deeper and deeper in the world.
כשהשיטפון החטא הזה שנכנס יותר עמוק ועמוק לעולם.
As the horrors of what's happening in the Middle East.
וכל הדברים הנוראים שקורים במזרח התיכון.
Thousands, thousands upon thousands have been slaughtered.
אלפים ואלפי אלפים שנטבחו.
Little Christian children being decapitated because they won't turn on Jesus.
משיחיים קרתו להם את הראשים בגלל שהם לא התכחשו לישוע.
All of these believers from Egypt, what happened to them?
כל המאמינים במצרים אתם יודעים מה שקרה להם.
But it's Muslims killing Muslims.
מוסלמים רוצחים מוסלמים.
All around our neighborhood.
כל השכונות של ישראל.
And some of you will remember we took an offering for the refugee children of Syria.
אתם זוכרים שאספנו תרומה עבור הילדים הפליטים של סוריה לא מזמן?
And we're putting together another team that's going to be going over to help out over there.
ואנחנו מארגנים שם קבוצה שתלך שם לעזור לפליטים.
And the family that was part of this congregation, we prayed for them here.
משפחה שהייתה חלק מקהילת הכרמל שהתפללנו עבורם כאן.
And yesterday they sent pictures.
אתמול שלחו תמונות.
The carpenter family and their children are bringing boxes of shoes and putting them on all these little Syrian refugee children.
המשפחה של סטיב קרפנטר הם שלחו תמונות עם ילדים שנושאים את הנעליים האלה והם שמחים שקיבלו אותם.
But as I watch the evil growing in the Middle East,
ככל שהחטא גודל וגובר במזרח התיכון,
hatred, hate, genocide, murder, mass murder,
רצח עם, רצח אנשים, שנאה וכל התועבות האלה,
this picture that we just saw, the picture we just looked at,
התמונה שעכשיו ראינו,
the handwriting is on the wall,
יד שכותבת על הקיר,
there is a hand,
יש יד
behind history.
מאחורי ההיסטוריה.
It's the hand of God.
זו היד של אלוהים.
Everything is under his control.
כל דבר תחת שליטתו.
He knows what's going on.
הוא יודע מה שקורה.
And at the crescendo of this horrible evil party,
כשמסיבת הרשע הגדולה הזאת שקרתה שם,
the Lord showed up.
האדון נתגלה.
And he engraved his words on the wall.
והוא חרט את דבריו על הקיר.
And what the words meant was this.
והפירוש של הדבר היה כזה.
Listen, king.
הקשיב מלך.
God has numbered your kingdom.
אלוהים מנה את ימיך.
It's finished.
וזה הושלם
נגמר. You have been weighed in the balances and found wanting.
אתה נשקלת במאזניים ונמצאת חסר.
Your kingdom will be divided.
נחלקה מלכותך.
And given to the Persians.
וניתנה לפרס.
That very night.
באותו לילה.
The Persians had attacked and that king was removed.
הפרסים תקפו והמלכות של המלך הזה נעלמה.
The hand of God is behind history.
יד האלוהים היא מאחורי ההיסטוריה.
It is not the kings.
זה לא המלכים.
It is not the presidents.
וזה לא הנשיאים.
It's not the unions of different political parties.
זה לא האחדות של כל מיני מפלגות פוליטיות.
It's God.
זה היד של אלוהים.
He praised the Lord.
השבח לאדון.
Amen. This scene.
המחזה הזה.
Who are the vessels of the temple today? Well, there's one. The rest of you don't know your vessels of the Holy Spirit, I guess. You're a vessel of the Holy Spirit
right here.
You don't want to be part of a situation where pollution is being put into your vessel, you as a vessel.
אתם לא רוצים להיות במצב שישימו בכם כל מיני תומה כשאתם כלים של האדון.
When Persia attacked,
כשפרס תקפה,
and Babylon crashed,
ובבל קרסה,
because of their ungodliness,
בגלל הרשע והחטא שלהם.
Look what happened.
תראו מה שקרה.
Turn to Isaiah chapter 44.
תפנו איתי אל ישעיה 44.
Isaiah 44. The handwriting is on the wall, friends.
And
the handwriting can be, God's handwriting can be found in this book. And he is victorious. Thank God that we had this victory shout in the camp here. Okay, Isaiah 44. Verse 28. Who says to Cyrus, he is my shepherd and shall perform all my pleasure, saying to Jerusalem, you shall be built, and to the temple your foundation shall be laid. For me, this is one of the most amazing of all the prophecies in the scripture. All the prophecies are amazing. But this is a prophecy by a Jewish prophet named Isaiah, who prophesied that a man named Cyrus would be the king of Persia, and that he would help the Jews come home and rebuild their temple. Cyrus was a Persian king. Now, that's amazing. But what's more amazing, this prophecy of Isaiah was written 200 years before Cyrus was born. 200 years before Cyrus was born, the hand of God was going to be on a man named Cyrus, who he's going to use for his purposes to bring the Jews home.
200 שנה לפני שנולד קורש, יד אלוהים הייתה עליו כדי שיחזיר את היהודים הביתה לירושלים.
Look at chapter 45, verse 1. The Lord is talking about a man named Cyrus, the king of Persia, who had not been born yet.
אלוהים מדבר על מלך בשם קורש, שהוא יהיה מלך פרס שעדיין לא נולד.
Thus says the Lord to his anointed. He's saying he will anoint this king to Cyrus, whom my right hand has seized. God's hand comes down in history. He seizes a king named Cyrus, who then tells Ezra and the others, I'm going to give you all this money. I'm going to give you all the vessels from the temple, take them back, and I'm going to give you everything you need to rebuild the temple in
Jerusalem.
He was anointed by God to free the Jews from captivity and bring them home. I wonder what Cyrus will be used in the nations now. Telling this precious group from Britain. We know that God had called them to be a Cyrus nation to bring the Jews back home.
Our
friends from Finland, you're called to be Cyrus to help the Jews come home. So Cyrus goes to Ezra and they start the project. Turn to Ezra chapter 1.
Verse 11.
The hand of God got a hold of a Persian king and drove him to God's purposes.
יד אלוהים אוחזת במלך פרס ומניעה אותו לעשות את מטרות אלוהים.
Ezra chapter 1 verse 1.
עזרא א' פסוק 1.
Now in the first year of Cyrus, king of Persia, which was right after the big party we just...
זה היה אחרי המסיבה הגדולה שקראנו עליה.
That the word of the Lord by the mouth of Jeremiah might be fulfilled, the Lord stirred up the spirit of Cyrus, king of Persia, so that he made a proclamation throughout all the kingdom and put it in writing.
Hallelujah.
The king of Persia sends out a proclamation to his kingdom. These Jews are going back to Jerusalem and restore the temple, and we're helping them. Ezra was the man that was used by the Lord to do this. Look at Ezra chapter 7. We just saw that the Lord's hand seized Cyrus. Have you ever been seized by the Lord? Anybody? I'm the only one.
אני היחידי.
I remember when I had to make a big decision in my life, it was like I was seized and he turned me around and said, do that.
אני זוכר שהייתי צריך לקבל החלטה חשובה בחיי, אלוהים אחז בי והפנה אותי לכיוון האחר.
God's hand.
יד אלוהים.
Is the hand behind history.
היא היד מאחורי ההיסטוריה.
It's the hand whose fingers made the stars.
היא היד שהאצבעות שלה הם עיצבו את הכוכבים.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
You need to know the touch of the Lord in your life.
אתם צריכים לדעת את ניגעת אלוהים בחייכם.
He wants to touch you.
הוא רוצה לגעת בכם.
He doesn't want to have to turn you around and push you somewhere. He just wants to touch you.
הוא לא רוצה לסובב אתכם בכוח, הוא רוצה לגעת בכם.
He wants to touch you with his love, his compassion.
לגעת בכם בחמלה, באהבה שלו.
He finds this wonderful one. This is like this scribe Ezra was a wonderful man of God.
הסופר הזה עזרא היה איש נפלא של אלוהים.
Ezra chapter 1.
עזרא.
Excuse me, chapter 7.
עזרא 7.
Verse 6.
פסוק 6.
Now Ezra came up from Babylon. He was a skilled scribe of the law of Moses, which the Lord of God of Israel had given. The king granted him all his requests according to the hand of the Lord his God upon him.
Amen. Hu Ezra alam mevavel vehu sofer ma'ir betorat Moshe asher natan Adonai Elohei Israel v'yiten lo.
They were in captivity.
Hem hayu be'avdut.
God got a hold of the king.
Elohim achaz b'melech.
He stirred up his spirit.
Vehu orer et ruho.
Said, go to Ezra and give them everything they need to go back to Israel.
Vehu natan le'Ezra et kol ma shehu zakuk kedei lachzor le'Israel.
Look at verse 9.
Pasuk 9.
From the first day of the month he began the journey, and on the first day of the fifth month he came to Jerusalem according to the good hand of his God upon him.
Ki be'echad l'chodesh ha'yashon hu yisod ha'alev mevavel, v'echad l'chodesh ha'chamishi ba'el Yerushalayim, k'yad Elohim ha'tova alav.
God was guiding Ezra all the way.
Elohim edrich et Ezra kol ha'derech.
There were robbers, there were bandits.
Hayu sham ganavim v'shodedim.
There were storms, there were valleys, there were mountains.
Hayu sham sufot, hayu amakim, harim.
He took him back with the good hand of his God was upon him.
Aval yad Elohim ha'tova hayta al Ezra.
You need to long to know that the good hand of your God
Atem
is on you.
להשתוקק שיד אלוהים הטובה תהיה עליכם.
You ever met anyone that you know the hand of God is on him?
האם פגשתם מישהו שיד אלוהים ראיתם
שיהיה
עליו?
Oh, you meet him. There's some of them are sitting in this room.
כמה מהאנשים שאני פגשתי יושבים כאן בחדר הזה.
That the hand of God is upon him.
יד אלוהים הייתה עליהם.
I think I'm going to embarrass Danny.
אני רוצה להביך את דני קצת.
Years ago,
לפני כמה שנים,
Danny and Luann, before they had their first baby,
דני ולואן לפני שנפגשו פעם ראשונה.
Danny got out of the army and got a job.
דני השתחרר מהצבא והתחיל לעבוד.
And we got to know them.
ואנחנו הכרנו אותם.
The Lord had told me the hand of the Lord was on him.
אלוהים אמר לי שיד ידו של אלוהים על דני.
Luann, the hand of the Lord was on you too.
וגם על לואן.
So I was in Helsinki, I think it was.
אני הייתי
Finland. Finland.
הייתי בפינלנד.
I was sitting with a person that ran a big organization.
וישבתי באיזה ארגון שם.
And said this wonderful question to me, what do you need?
שאלו אותי, למה אתה זקוק?
How can we help?
איך אפשר לעזור?
I said, oh, what we need is we need a salary for a guy who the hand of God is on him.
אמרתי להם, אנחנו זקוקים למשכורת לאדם שיד אלוהים עליו.
He's called to be a pastor. He's called to be a pastor.
והוא נקרא להיות רואה.
So some years later, he became a pastor.
אחרי כמה שנים הוא הפך לרואה.
Why?
למה?
Because the hand of God was on him.
כי יד אלוהים עליו.
Because there was something in him that God said, "Here's somebody that I can use."
כי מישהו אלוהים מצא בו מישהו שיכול להשתמש בו.
Hallelujah! I mean, there's people all over here. I could choose. The same thing has happened to me.
יש כל כך הרבה אנשים כאן שחוו את אותה חוויה.
We need to long for the touch of God.
אנחנו צריכים להשתוקק לנגיעה מאלוהים.
The touch of God in your life.
נגיעת אלוהים בחייכם.
That He's touching you.
הוא נוגע בכם.
That He's leading you.
הוא מדריך אתכם.
That He's directing you.
והוא מכוון אתכם.
This is what we need.
זה מה שאנו זקוקים
לו. I want to be a man touched by God, and I want to feel that experience the touch of the Lord continually.
אני רוצה נגיעה מאלוהים, ואני רוצה שהנגיעה הזאת תהיה ממושכת.
Now, why did he choose Ezra?
מדוע הוא בחר בעזרא?
Why did he choose Danny?
מדוע הוא בחר בדני?
Why did he choose Peter?
מדוע הוא בחר בפיטר?
Why did he choose any of you?
מדוע הוא בחר בכל אחד מכם?
Choose people to come from YWAM, from I don't know, you're all over the place.
מדוע הוא בחר באנשים משירות לצעירים?
Why did he choose you to come from Kona, Hawaii, to be here today?
מדוע הוא בחר בכם לבוא מהוואי ולהיות כאן איתנו?
The eyes of the Lord are always looking to and fro around the world for somebody whose heart is continually turned to Him. And then He puts His hand on.
עיני אלוהים מסתובבות בכל העולם מחפשות אנשים שהלב שלהם שלם איתו כדי להשתמש בהם.
Look at chapter 7.
פרק
Verse 10. Here's the reason. Here is how you get the touch of God in your life. This is why God used Ezra. Verse 10. Ezra had prepared his heart to seek the law of the Lord and to do it.
כי עזרא הכין לבבו לדרוש את תורת אדוני ולעשות.
Ezra was a man that loved the word of God.
עזרא היה איש שאהב את דבר אלוהים.
You need to prepare your heart every morning to seek the word of the Lord.
אתם צריכים להכין את ליבכם כל בוקר לדרוש את פני האדון.
It's where the transformation takes place.
שמה מגיע השינוי.
Ezra prepared his heart to seek the word of the Lord and to do it.
עזרא הכין את ליבו לדרוש את פני האדון ולעשות את דברו.
You know, some of you know that I've gone through a kind of a difficult week.
כמה מכם יודעים שאני עברתי תקופה קשה לפני שבוע?
My wife told me this morning she has a word for me.
קרן אמרה לי שיש לי דבר עבורך.
She said it's about walking through the afflictions of David.
אמרה לי, אתה הולך בצרות של דוד.
Remember David and his afflictions. Okay. It's about King David, but she applied it to me. So I don't remember my afflictions because I got touched in the worship. If you come to a worship meeting and the hand of God doesn't touch you, something's wrong with you. The manifest presence of God comes and you don't want to be touched by the by it.
כשנוכחות אלוהים מגיעה, איך אתם יכולים להישאר בלי נגיעה ממנו?
Ezra was a man who devoured the word of God and he did it.
עזרא טרף את דבר אלוהים והוא פעל ועשה את דבר אלוהים.
So God said, I'll put my hand on him and use him to change history.
אלוהים אמר, אני אניח את ידי על עזרא ואשנה את ההיסטוריה.
Look what it says.
תראו מה הוא אומר.
He had prepared his heart to seek the Lord and to do it and to teach the statutes and ordinances in Israel.
כי עזרא הכין לבבו לדרוש את תורת אדוני ולעשות וללמד בישראל חוק ומשפט.
When the hand of the Lord comes on you,
כשיד אלוהים נוחתת עליכם,
and you're touched by the Holy Spirit, you're touched by the Lord,
אתם מקבלים נגיעה מרוח הקודש מהאדון.
If you've prepared, the British people have to go, see you, Mike, great to see you. Here's a wonderful congregation. We did a conference there. Thanks for coming. Hallelujah. Turn to Isaiah chapter 11.
תפנו את ישעיה י' א'.
Isaiah chapter 11, we're talking about the hand behind history.
אנחנו מדברים על היד שמאחורי ההיסטוריה.
Isaiah 11.
ישעיה י' א'.
Verse 11.
פסוק 11.
It's one of the verses that changed my life.
אחד הפסוקים ששינה את חיי.
Isaiah 11:11. It shall come to pass in that day is this day, that the Lord shall set his hand again, not the Babylonian, not Ezra bringing the people back a second time again, to recover the remnant of his people who are left. He will redeem them and he will possess them and he'll bring them back. Elam here is Syria, Iran.
Elam ze Iran.
He will set up a banner or a sign to the nations. Assemble the outcasts of Israel, gather together the dispersed of Judah from the four corners of the earth. Let me say this to you. We are living in this moment right now. The hand of the Lord has brought the people back. God did it. And God is still doing it. It's the hand of God that's doing it. And woe to anybody that comes against the purposes of God. The hand of God brought the people here. The hand of God is bringing them by the hundreds from the Ukraine right now. They're coming from France. It's happening again. Oh, it looks bad. The anti-Semitism all over Europe. But let me tell you a secret. The handwriting is on the wall for those nations. And the handwriting is on the wall for this nation because he's bringing them back from all over the world. All over the former Soviet Union. Praise the Lord. We're sitting in a prophetic moment on Mount Carmel right now. God's hand is moving things around in history. You may not understand it all, but he's doing it. When the hand of the Lord comes on somebody or a nation, it represents power. You need the power of God in your life. Thank God some of us started jumping and shouting about the power of God in this word. We need the power of God in our life. No weapon formed against us shall prosper. Hallelujah. We need to walk in that. We need to believe it. We need to memorize it. We need to put it in our heart. The hand of the Lord means power. It means protection. It means provision. Everything that Ezra needed, he got. Super abundantly more than he needed. This is what the hand of the Lord coming on somebody is all about. It's the prophetic. The hand of the Lord comes on somebody and a word of prophecy comes through. Did the hand of the Lord come on Elijah? The hand of the Lord came on Elijah is what the scripture says.
And
he ran from here over 26 miles over there. And he wasn't even tired. Maybe it was the first marathon. The hand of the Lord came on him and he ran ahead of Jahab's chariot. Did the hand of the Lord, it was the power of God came on him. Why? Because God found somebody he could use and he could empower him. Don't you want to walk in this kind of victory? Hallelujah. His spiritual son, Elisha, They're out on the battlefield. Surrounded by enemies, just like today. They're running out of water. The animals are going to die. The army is going to die.
The three kings
are having their meetings and can't figure out what to do. Jehoshaphat says, is there a prophet of the Lord anywhere around here that knows of the word of God? They said, yeah, Elisha's over there in that tent. Elisha comes out. There's the kings. The soldiers are terrified they're going to be overrun by the enemy. So they say to Elisha, what should we do? Elisha says, bring me a musician. The kings went, what? What did he say? What, he's going to sing a song? Well, what is going on here? Bring a musician. The enemy is about to attack us. They got weapons. Somebody comes out with a harp. Starts playing. What does the scripture say? The hand of the Lord came on
Elisha.
In the worship. He heard the word of the Lord. Dig ditches all over this place. He saved the nation. One man. Because he knew how to worship the Lord. In the midst of a war, the hand of the Lord came on him.
And
the Lord gave him the answer. We're in the midst of a war. We are in a spiritual war. Whether you know it or not, you're in a spiritual war. And if you will get along with the Lord, even if on the battlefield, you need to train yourself to worship the Lord, and the hand of the Lord will come upon you. Glory to God. Don't you want the hand of the Lord to come upon you? Turn to Psalm 89.
Psalm 89.
Verse 20. I have found my servant David. God was looking for David. David didn't know what his future was, but God was looking for somebody whose heart was after his own. He found
David.
Him. I have found my servant David. With my holy oil I have anointed him, with whom my hand shall be established, and my arm shall strengthen him. Isn't this wonderful? A little shepherd boy, probably playing his harp. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. The most beautiful worship songs the world has ever known from this young man.
They've
impacted millions of people for thousands of years and still do every day all around the world. As he worshiped the Lord, the Lord chose him, he found him. And he put his hand on his son. The hand of the Lord came on David. Hallelujah.
Amen.
What is the true center of history? Alexander the Great thought it was him. He drank himself to death when he was 32 years old, but he thought he was the king of kings. The Assyrians thought they were the center of history.
השורים חשבו שהם מרכז ההיסטוריה.
ISIS thinks they're going to be the center of history.
דאעש חושבים שהם מרכז ההיסטוריה.
Iran thinks they'll be the center of history.
איראן חושבת שהיא תהיה מרכז ההיסטוריה.
The Third Reich, they thought they would be the center of history.
הרייך השלישי חשב שהם יהיו מרכז ההיסטוריה.
Communist movement in Russia, they thought they would be the center of history.
התנועה הקומוניסטית ברוסיה חשבו שהם מרכז ההיסטוריה.
My friends, none of those are the center of history.
ידידיי, אף אחד מאלה הוא לא מרכז ההיסטוריה.
The center of history.
מרכז ההיסטוריה.
Is a man.
זה איש.
His name is Yeshua.
שמו ישוע.
His hand is directing everything.
ידו מדריכה הכל.
You could walk through Israel.
אתם יכולים להתהלך בישראל.
But you come to little Jerusalem in those days.
שאתם מגיעים אל ירושלים הקטנה בימים האלה.
People walking through Israel.
אנשים מתהלכים בישראל.
They didn't go to the temple.
אתם הולכים אל בית
המקדש.
They
didn't go to the palace.
או אל הארמון.
They didn't go to the king's house.
או אל מלך, בית המלך.
They went to a little Jerusalem.
אני הלכתי לירושלים הקטנה.
And there was a little hill.
והייתה שם גבעה קטנה.
And a man was nailed to a cross.
ואדם שסומר על הצלב.
Cruel spikes driven through the
head. שמו מסמרים בידיים, ברגליים שלו.
His hands were wide open.
הידיים שלו היו מושטות לגמרי.
The blood dripping down.
והדם ירד.
This is the hand behind history.
זאת היד שמובילה את ההיסטוריה.
He said it's finished.
הוא אמר, תם ונשלם.
Satan and his demons thought, we won, we won.
כל השדים חשבו שהם ניצחו.
Three days later, he exploded out of that tomb.
אחרי שלושה ימים ישוע קם מן הקבר.
He showed Thomas's hands.
והוא הראה את ידו עם החורים.
And he said, blessed who have seen, but blessed are you even more so that haven't seen.
והוא אמר שברוכים אלה שרואים את המראה הזה.
His hands.
הידיים שלו.
Are reaching out.
מושטות.
To anyone who would have him.
לכל אחד שמוכן לקבל אותו.
This is the hand behind history.
זו היד שהיא מרכז ההיסטוריה.
This is the hand that wrote on the wall.
זו היד שכתבה על הקיר.
This is the hand that was on Elijah.
זו היד שהייתה על אליהו.
This is the hand that was on David.
זו היד שהייתה על דוד.
We need a touch from the Lord.
אנחנו זקוקים לנגיעה
מהאדון. We need to know the hand of the Lord directing our life.
אנחנו זקוקים שהאדון ידריך את חיינו.
All the famous people bypassed that little
כל האנשים המפורסמים שעברו ליד הגבעה הזאת.
Who is he? All things were created through him and for him.
בו נברא ולמענו נברא.
This is the hand that's behind history.
זו היד שמניעה את ההיסטוריה.
It's the hand of our God.
זו היד של אלוהינו.
It still has holes in his hand.
יש את החורים
בידיו. When we meet him in glory, we will see those hands.
אפילו בכבוד אנחנו נראה את החורים בידיים שלו.
This is the hand that is moving history.
זו היד שמניעה את ההיסטוריה.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
All things were created through him and for him.
הכל נברא באמצעותו ולמענו.
I want to finish with something.
אני רוצה לסיים עם משהו.
Who is hanging on that cross?
מי נתלה על הצלב הזה?
This is who he said he was.
זה מי שאמר שהוא.
I'm the Alpha.
אני האלף.
I'm the Omega.
אני התו.
I'm the beginning.
אני הראשון.
I'm the end.
ואני האחרון.
Who is.
אשר היה.
And was.
והווה.
And is to come.
ויבוא.
This is the hand that is behind history.
זו היד שמאחורי ההיסטוריה.
Years ago.
לפני כמה שנים.
We went to hear David Wilkerson speak.
אנחנו נסענו לשמוע את דייוויד וילקרסון מטיף.
He had come back to New York to start a congregation.
הוא חזר לניו יורק והתחיל שם קהילה.
I was so impacted by that man.
אני כל כך הושפעתי על ידי האדם הזה.
It was the anointing that was on him.
כי המשיכה הייתה עליו.
As we got on the driving home, going home in the subway.
כשנסענו הביתה ברכבת התחתית.
She can't stop crying.
קרן לא יכלה להפסיק לבכות.
She's sobbing on the subway.
היא בכתה ברכבת התחתית.
Frankly, it was embarrassing.
זה היה קצת מביך.
I mean, I'm wondering, what do these people think I did to her?
אנשים חשבו שעשיתי לה משהו.
Finally, I said, what is it?
בסוף אמרתי, מה קורה?
She said, the hand of God is on me.
יד אלוהים עליי.
The hand of God.
יד אלוהים עליי.
Our whole history changed because a few days later we met that man and
כל ההיסטוריה שלנו השתנתה בגלל שמצאנו
פגשנו את somebody he could put his hand on.
שאלוהים מוצא מישהו הוא שם את ידו עליו.
The Lord wants to do this with all of us that we know that the hand of the Lord is resting upon us and guiding us.
אדון רוצה לעשות את זה עם כולנו לדעת שיד אלוהים נוחתת עלינו ומדריכה אותנו.
And they brought the little children to him.
ואז הביאו אל ישוע ילדים
That he might touch them.
כדי שהוא ייגע בהם.
Yeshua loved for the little children to come to him, and the disciples said, "Get these kids out of here."
Yeshua אהב שהילדים יתקרבו, אבל התלמידים גערו בהם.
He was laying his hands on the children.
הוא סמך את ידיו על הילדים.
The Creator of the universe.
בורא העולם.
Came down in human form.
ירד בדמות של אדם.
That he might lay hands on the dead, and they would be raised from the dead.
כדי לסמוך ידיים על המתים ולהקים אותם.
He would put his hands on eyes, and the eyes that couldn't see would see.
והוא סמך את ידיו על העברים והם התחילו לראות.
Let the little children come to me.
הניחו לילדים לבוא אליי.
Do not forbid them.
ואל תמנעו מהם.
Such is the kingdom of God.
כי לכאלה מלכות האלוהים.
Amen, amen, I say to you.
Amen, amen, אני אומר לכם.
Whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will by no means enter into it.
כל מי שאיננו מקבל את מלכות אלוהים כילד לא ייכנס לתוכה.
He took them up in his arms.
הוא לקח אותם בזרועותיו.
And he laid those precious hands on them.
והוא הניח את ידיו היקרות
עליהם. We need to come to him as a little child.
אתם רוצים לבוא אליו כילדים צעירים.
I want your hand on me.
אדון, אני רוצה שהידיים שלך יחבקו אותי.
I need your guidance.
אני זקוק ל...
I need your healing.
ריפוי שלך, אדון.
I need your direction.
אני זקוק לכיוון.
I need your revelation.
אני זקוק להתגלות.
I need your anointing.
אני זקוק למשיכה.
Come to me. And if you don't come as a little child, you won't enter into the kingdom of God. You'll be on the edge of outer darkness, another kingdom. The Lord is stretching out his hands to us. They're nail-scarred hands now, which he did for us.
And he says,
come to me as a little child, and I will touch you.
כילדים קטנים ואני אגע בכם.
How many of you are desperate for the touch of God?
כמה מכם נואשים לנגיעה מהאדון?
Come as a little child, just come now.
כילדים קטנים אל המזבח.
Let's stand. Come as a little child.
תבואו קדימה כילדים קטנים.
Leave your pride.
תעזבו את הגאווה שלכם.
Just come as a little kid.
בואו כילדים.
The hand of God is behind your histories, writing your book.
יד אלוהים מאחורי ההיסטוריה וכותבת ספר חייכם.
Hallelujah. What a magnificent gospel the Lord has given us.
איזו בשורה נפלאה אלוהים נתן לנו.
That the creator of the universe.
שבורא עולם.
Would come down in human form.
ירד בדמות של אדם.
And he stretched out his hands and nailed him to a cross. The hand that had written on the wall in Babylon. The hand that had come on David and Elijah. The hand that had grabbed a hold of Cyrus. He wants to touch you. Come as a little child. Little children are innocent.
הילדים תמימים.
They don't know that they're doing bad things sometimes.
אפילו שהם עושים דברים נוראים
לפעמים. You just tell him to cleanse you.
אלוהים רוצה לתאר אתכם.
If there's anything obstructing the hand of God touching you,
אם משהו מונע מאלוהים לגעת בכם,
He'll heal you.
תמסרו את זה.
He'll heal your mind.
תשתחררו מזה.
He'll touch your heart.
הוא ייגע בלבכם במחשבותיכם.
You'll know the touch of the master.
אתם זקוקים לנגיעה של האדון.
He's the potter.
הוא היוצר.
He will shape us.
הוא יעצב אותנו.
He will make us a vessels of honor fit for the master.
הוא יהפוך אותנו לכלים של כבוד מתאימים לעבודת האדון.
He's here.
הוא נמצא כאן.
For anyone who will.
לכל אלה שחפצים.
He's here.
הוא נמצא כאן.
Saying, I want to touch you.
אני רוצה לגעת בכם.
Open your heart.
תפתחו את לבכם.
Just like Ezra.
כפי שעזרא עשה.
He had an open heart.
היה לו לב פתוח.
The Lord wants to touch your heart.
אדון רוצה לגעת בלבכם.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Can you thank him? All you can do is thank him. The hand of the Lord on us. The hand of the Lord.
Yad Elohim.
Touching us as little children.
Nogat banu keiladim ktanim.
Oh God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Let's pray this prayer together.
Bo nitpalel tfila kazot beyachad.
Father, thank you for sending Yeshua.
Abba, toda sheshalachta et Yeshua.
Yeshua, thank you for coming.
Yeshua, toda shebata.
Thank you for choosing to come.
Toda shebacharta lavo, Adon.
Thank you.
Toda, Adon.
For allowing them to nail you to that cross.
Sheifsharta lehem lesamer otcha al hatzlav.
But we believe.
Anachnu ma'aminim.
We haven't seen the hands, but we believe.
שעדיין לא ראינו את היד של האמונה.
Forgive us.
סלח לנו, אדון.
For not thanking you enough.
שאנחנו לא מודים לך מספיק.
Lord, would you begin touching people?
אדון, אנחנו מודים לך שאתה נוגע באנשים.
They don't need a touch of a man, they need a touch of you.
תיגע באנשים שנוגעים בך, אדון.
Touch each one, Lord.
תיגע בכל אחד מאיתנו.
Love the little children.
אתה אוהב את הילדים הקטנים.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
I want the touch of God in my life.
אני רוצה את נגעת אלוהים בחיי.
If you do, you tell the Lord.
אני רוצה שאלוהים ישתמש בי.
Whatever it costs, Lord, I want your touch.
לא משנה כמה שזה יעלה, אני זקוק לנגיעה שלך, אדון.
Because you've paid the ultimate price.
אתה שילמת את המחיר הסופי.
Let's worship him.
בואו נשתחווה לו.
Lord, touch it. Lord, touch us as we worship you.
אדון, תיגע בנו כשאנחנו משתחווים לך.
Jew, Arab, Gentile, worshiping you together.
Arabim, Goyim, kulam, mishtachavim lacha, Adon.
He is, he was, he always will be. He's the hand behind history. He's the hand behind your story. History is his story.
Yeshua Adon, Hakol Nivra Be'em Sato, Hakol Nivra Le'mano, Ukodem Lakol Bo Kayam Hakol Ha'alev Adon.
Beginning and the end. First and the last, everlasting God.